Jimmy dropped just before it reached him. From the top of the rise above him shot a blinding eye of light. It pierced the distance to the northward for an instant, settled to the ground with a jerk, and swept in a gigantic arc over the country, slowly scouring the open places, illuminating the brush. Jimmy dropped just before it reached him, flattening his face in the sand. He could see the white glare all about him for a time. Then it became dark again, and he looked up to see the finger of white drilling the night far away. The man took a long chance on the open country and made a cautious run for it. He went quietly until his foot slipped and he went down, banging his head on a rock. The blow made him dizzy, and the noise he made terrified him. But he got up and stumbled along in the darkness, ready to flop to the ground the instant the searchlight turned his way again. He gained the timbered stretch that was above and breathed easier. It was more difficult to travel, of course, for the brush was stiff and thick, but he was under cover at least. Jimmy reached out his hand to draw aside what, in the darkness, looked like a vine. The points of barbed wire dug into the flesh of his hands, and he stood very still for a long time, listening for footsteps. Once more came the finger of light, and he squatted in the bushes, while it made the stunted forest glow. With great difficulty, Jimmy wormed his way through the wire. It cut his clothes and pricked his flesh, but he did not heed. On he went again, making every move take him nearer the crest of the hill, and making every motion as near noiseless as was possible. He worked his way through another wire net, worse than the first. Then the light came back, and he lay still for a long time. Perhaps it was a fortunate thing that he did feel compelled to lay still, for he heard something, a faint and regular sound. He pressed his ear to the ground and strained to listen. It grew stronger, stopped, receded, and died away. After a time, it came back again, growing stronger, but not strong, stopping, and after a deliberate interval, resuming, only to die off. Lieutenant Croghan crawled with greater care than ever. He struck his hand against a mescal plant and gritted his teeth to keep back a cry of surprise and pain. He suddenly thought that if he had eaten something, he might have been steadier. However, there was nothing to eat, so he set his mind back to his work. He went on, like a careful cat. After he had crawled 50 yards more and stopped to listen, he heard the sound plainly. In fact, he could hear the boots that made it swishing through the grass. He waited until the sentry reached the end of his post and turned back. With utmost caution then, he hurried along for many yards, stopped, scarcely breathing, and waited while the soldier came and went again. Thus, he proceeded. 2 more wire webs ripped his clothes and haggled his flesh. 3 more sentries patrolled the path he took. Out of the brush, he worked. Out of the brush, he worked, into the open strip, not 400 yards from the ridge, where low bushes and heavy grasses grew thickly. He crawled a short way into this and then sat up, looking about boldly. He held his breath as he turned his head this way and that, but the only sound he could hear was the occasional footstep of the sentry he had last left behind.